Hello everybody, Hassan Sharik, Regulated Canadian Immigration Consultant, talking to all of you from the Canadian city of Mississauga. It's a beautiful sunny morning here in most parts of Toronto here. And there's some exciting news that I wanted to share with all of you through this video. We've had another express entry draw. It was a targeted draw, CEC only, and the CRS has had a dip once again. As I mentioned that this was a CEC draw, so about 3,000 plus CEC applicants who received the invitations to apply. My well wishes with all of you. You now have about 90 days to proceed with collecting all the required documents and submitting those for your PR application. Good luck in this process, and hopefully you can do the process smoothly and are able to obtain the Canadian permanent residency soon. Looking at the draw itself and some takeaways. So one good thing, we see that frequent draws are happening. There was a draw yesterday, which was only PNP, and about 2 weeks ago, 16th of April, we had a draw in which CEC applicants were invited. So we clearly see that IRCC is continuing its operations and immigration processing is ongoing. There was a dip in CRS as well, which is positive. The draw itself, 3,311 ITAs were issued. The tie-breaking date was October. This was 10th of October 2019, and the cutoff was 452. Now, if we compare the cutoff for the draw which happened today and the draw which happened on the 16th of April, the dip in CRS is only very small, about 3 CRS points, but there is a dip. So clearly it shows that CRS are expected to fall down if we see the same frequency of draw continuing over next few weeks and months. Moving towards the federal skilled worker program applicants, the bad part is that the pattern is continuing. It seems IRCC is going to continue with the policy of not inviting federal skilled worker program applicants right now. The good pieces, the good takeaways that I would like to share with you guys. First, CRS dropping. So that means that whenever we have a draw for federal skilled worker applicants, we will see CRS scores of below 470s for sure. I'm pretty hopeful based on my own data analysis that it might be 460s, but it can actually drop to 450s as well. Looking at the numbers, and IRCC has not shared the numbers for 30th of April. The data that they shared was for 27th of April, so we do not know what happened in between these 3 days. But adding the number of invites for today and yesterday, so about 4,000 people have moved out of the of Express Entry pool who were within the score range of 450 to 1,200. And more importantly, now there are 3,000 lesser people in the score range of 451 to 5,000. Now, this is where a lot of you are. Keep in mind that the score dropped from 455 to 452. So this actually means that there is a good number of applicants in 450s and 460s. So that's where it is. I would like to add over here that in my personal opinion, I don't think that IRCC can hold on to the policy of not issuing the Federal Skilled Worker Program ITAs for a little too long. They might not invite people from this category, say for a month or maybe for 2 months, but beyond that, it might not be something which is sustainable. For the reason that if they have to achieve the immigration targets for this particular year, then they have to move on towards the policy of inviting federal skilled worker program applicants. There are ways that they can still manage it. So we all know that now they've increased the number of days from 60 to 90 in which you have to submit your documents, and this is post-COVID-19. So such an extension can be provided. There are leverages, like if you are not able to provide a police certificate till your deadline date, but you've already applied for it and you applied well in time, they allow you some leverage in that. So, they can always come up with these flexibilities in terms of document submission deadlines, even if they invite the Federal Skilled Worker Program applicants. So, there will come a time, and this is my opinion, there will come a time where they will have to sit down if this situation persists and make a decision as to what they can do in order to invite the Federal Skilled Worker Program applicants to achieve the immigration targets that they have for this particular year. So I don't see many of you who are stuck in the pool and not getting ITAs because you're the Federal Skilled Worker Program applicants waiting for maybe too long. When does that actually happen that you get your ITAs? This is something that we all have to wait and see. So this is all from my side. Some positives, some not so positives, but I would recommend all of you, the Federal Skilled Worker Program applicants, to stay positive. My prayers and wishes with you, and hopefully in say a month or 2 months' time, a lot of you who are in the scores of 460s for sure, and maybe 450s, can start to see invitations, and you can proceed further with your dream of getting the Canadian permanent residency. That's about it from my side. With any other update and some other Canadian immigration information, I will be coming back and talking to you guys through another video soon. Till that time, take care.